Good morning and welcome to On The Pulse. I'm your host, Leslie Moy. On the 1st of June, the city of Bulawayo celebrated its 126th anniversary of the declaration of Bulawayo as a town, with various organizations and residents taking to online platforms to celebrate the milestone. The love that the people of Bulawayo have for the city has been shown by the various donations to the city as well as to vulnerable members of the community in light of the coronavirus outbreak. Yesterday, Stanbic Bank donated personal protective clothing for the frontline healthcare workers at a time when there's an increase in COVID-19 cases in the city as well as nationally. Zimbabwe Cricket also chipped in with sanitizers and medication. As part of the city celebrations, the local authority also handed over some food parcels to some of the city's celebrated artists through the Bulawayo Arts, Culture and Heritage Endowment Fund.
Thank you, Councillor Mlilo. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll go to our handover ceremony. Siyabonga kakhulu ukuthi lilapha to witness this very special handover. Today we've got Stanbic Bank. I'll invite Mrs. Selisi Chavinda, who is standing in for the bank, to please come and give us a speech as she hands over. Yabonga.
A very good evening to you all. All protocol observed. Stanbic Bank is grateful for the opportunity to be here today as we put our hands together as a nation to fight the COVID-19 pandemic. Since the pandemic started, we have all gone through different emotions and have had to mentally prepare ourselves to fight for our health and even our economy as we follow the lead of our government in mitigating the spread of the virus while keeping essential services up and running. We have seen frontline workers from various sectors serve our people with so much courage and hope. Their commitment has given us strength to join to be in the fight by staying at home to protect ourselves and them. There are many frontline workers, and we appreciate their efforts. And today, we are here to support the medical frontliners who can in no way escape or avoid this war, as they are the backbone of the survival of our people, even when we are not in times of crisis. Stanbic Bank has committed a total of $200,000 to the purchase of PPEs, ventilators, COVID-19 PCR tests, and boreholes. The PPEs are being donated at Wilkins Hospital, Gweru Provincial Hospital, Mashingo Provincial Hospital, Mutare Infectious Disease Hospital. We have already handed over to St. Anne's Hospital in Harare today, and we are here for Thorngrove Hospital. Our healthcare workers cannot function without our personal protective equipment, and we appreciate the risk involved when discharging their duties. As Stanbic Bank, we have donated to Thorngrove the following: protective suits, 500 of those. There they are. Surgical masks, 3,750 boxes. Face shields, 125 of them. N19 masks, 750. They are in the boxes. Unfortunately, we didn't remove them. Goggles, amagogoros, 500 of those. And gloves, 5,000. We will also provide one ventilator for Thorngrove Hospital, which, however, is yet to be delivered due to high global demand. The bank is also in the process of drilling two boreholes for the communities in Glenora C in Harare, and here in Bulawayo, we identified Cowdery Park. Water is essential for our livelihood, and we join these communities in easing the prevailing water challenges in these areas to reduce the risk of contracting the disease, including COVID-19. A Stanbic team goes around to countries handing over these goods. We would like to take this opportunity to applaud our healthcare workers and encourage them to keep the work going. These and other donations should give you, our healthcare workers, courage and confidence to attend to our citizens in their time of need. We thank our corporate organizations and well-wishers who have donated before us and encourage more to do the same. This is a battle for all mankind. As a country, we will overcome this and we continue rebuilding our nation. I thank you.
Thank you. A big hand for Stan Big and a big hand for Mrs. Chavinda. Such generosity. Siyabonga kakhulu. Ladies and gentlemen, somebody called R. Akiva said, the world could not even exist one moment without acts of kindness. It is these acts of kindness that have allowed us to go through what we are going through in terms of the coronavirus pandemic. The city has received so many donations from big corporates, SMEs, individuals, and we are very excited. At this point, I will invite Zimbabwe Cricket, represented by Mr. Nick Singo, to please give us their donation.
Good evening, distinguished ladies and gentlemen. All protocols observed. We are facing a global health crisis which is killing plenty of people and spreading human suffering. And the COVID-19, which has been characterized as a pandemic by World Health Organization, is attacking society at their core. With this in mind, Zimbabwe Cricket has been trying its best to assist where it can. Just in the past 2 weeks, we have gone to Entembeni and disinfected the whole complex. We also went to Percy Epson. We also did the same and donated some sanitizers as well as some masks. Today, again in our small way, we have got a small donation of medicinal essentials for Thorngrove Infectious Disease Hospital, which has been designated as a COVID-19 isolation center. We brought some hand sanitizers, some hand soap, paracetamol, and some cough syrup. In conclusion, as Zimbabwe Cricket would like to congratulate City of Bulawayo on its 126th anniversary. City Amhlophe, Bulawayo Omuhle. Siyabonga.
Siyabonga. Thank you, Zimbabwe Cricket, for reaching out to our city and for continuing to be mindful of the frontline workers that are in the frontline to fight COVID-19 and also to empower and equip our hospital, Thorngrove Hospital. Ladies and gentlemen, as we celebrate this week, we are celebrating Bulawayo, our heritage as a cultural hub, but we are also celebrating our creativity. Allow me to invite Bulawayo Arts, Culture and Heritage Endowment Fund, represented by Mr. Josh Nyapimbi, to come and make their donation.
Thank you, Programs Director. All protocol observed. On behalf of the Bulawayo Arts, Culture and Heritage Endowment Fund, we are proud to be the official sponsors of Bulawayo Day and the inaugural Bulawayo Arts Festival. We are also grateful and would like to acknowledge the support in funds that is going to be extended by the government of Zimbabwe through the National Arts Council. We thought it was important that we recognize the challenges that our senior artists, as senior citizens of this city, are facing in accessing the most basic commodity, which is millimeter. And in our humble way, we could not cover as many deserving senior artists, but due to limited resources at this inaugural Bulawayo Arts Festival, we thought would extend our support to Ilubalemvelo, the Cool Crooners, and Tandanani Women's Group. We hope, resources permitting, we'll be able to occasionally extend whatever support is key and is timely to our senior citizens, as represented by our senior artists in the community. At this point, I would like to invite a representative from the Cool Crooners to come and receive a donation from us. Upon a representative from Ilubalemvelo to receive our kind donation. Our last donation is extended to Tandanani, their representative.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for that generosity. Bakhulumile omama bathi asigeze izandla. I remember reading somewhere, someone was saying, ah, what is gezi zandla? Gatum zimba sa gezi. Ay, as gezi ningonke, as gezi umzimba, but it's best look as gezi zandla kakhulu. Siyabonga kakhulu. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to welcome His Worship, the Mayor of the City of Bulawayo, to officially acknowledge the donations and to thank our partners who have made all this possible. Ngiyabonga.
Thank you, Director of Proceedings, Ms. Mpofu. Good evening, Bulawayo. May I acknowledge the presence of the Chairperson of the Health, Housing and Education Committee, who is also the Chairperson of the City's Task Force on COVID-19, Councillor Elm Lilo, the Branch Manager, Stanbic Bank, Ms. S. Chivinda. We also have from the city the Director of Youth Services, Dr. Isbanda. We have the General Manager for Tuskers Cricket Franchise, Mr. N. Singo, a representative from Bachef, Josh Nyapimbi, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen. The City of Bulawayo celebrates its 126th anniversary of the Declaration of Bulawayo as a town on the 1st of June 1894. It is our honor that the city has achieved such a milestone, and many organizations of different sons and daughters of Bulawayo spent the day yesterday congratulating the city and also highlighting why the city is very close to their hearts. The messages were indeed humbling and were a reflection of the love that the people of Bulawayo have for their city. As we stand once again today to receive donations for the fight against the COVID-19 pandemic, I reflect back to the messages that we got as a city and recognize that indeed Bulawayo would not have achieved what it has attained without the contributions of its residents. It is an indication that the success of for the next 100 years for Bulawayo will also come from the contributions of the people of Bulawayo. We are humbled as a city that today we are receiving donations from Stanbic Bank, who have seen it fit to assist with personal protective clothing for the frontline healthcare staff, particularly at a time when we are witnessing an increase in the number of new infections in the city and in the country. This donation, ladies and gentlemen, will go a long way in attending to the increased number of cases and also increase the city's preparedness towards the COVID-19 response. May I also take this opportunity to appreciate the donations from Zimbabwe Cricket, the Tuskers franchise. We have noted that the sporting community is also key in the fight against COVID-19. The donation is also to ensure that the already burdened community has access to expensive medication. The challenges of the COVID-19 lockdown has been felt on a number of professionals in Zimbabwe. The art industry is one such that has felt the impact of the national lockdown and the restrictions that comes with the lockdown. I am pleased, therefore, that as part of the city's celebrations, we will today be handing over some food parcels to some of the city's greatest artists. We have seen the co-crooners receiving the donations from the Bulawayo Arts Culture Heritage Endowment Fund, Bachef. This is not only to celebrate Bulawayo's 126th anniversary, but also to remember that we are our neighbor's keeper. It is my hope that this noble initiative will continue going forward and will cater for more people even after COVID. Since last week, we have seen a reemergence of the COVID-19 cases in the city, breaking our streak of more than 23 days without new COVID-19 cases. The number of rapid response teams have been increased to follow up on the contacts of the increased number of cases, and we are doing our level best to straighten the curve so that we have enough resources to cater for the cases. I am pleased that most of these cases are mild. The new cases are, however, a reflection that we need to be diligent in ensuring that we reduce the spread of COVID-19 in our city. With the easing up of lockdown, it is important to ensure that we wear our face mask at all times in the public spaces and also ensure that we practice social distancing. The government of Zimbabwe and the Zimbabwe Republic Police are also calling on each and every one of us to report the members of the public who would have escaped quarantine centers. This will help ensure that we do not expose ourselves and our families and friends to COVID-19. Making these reports would also be our contribution to the fight against this deadly pandemic. Ladies and gentlemen, may we remain cautious and safe. We should continue to practice social distancing, washing of hands, and avoid unnecessary traveling. Let us remain vigilant and compliant to avoid to COVID-19 protocols. I thank you.
I too hope that the spirit of Ubuntu that we've seen being exhibited by various organizations and individuals will continue. Let's take care of our loved ones. Let's take care of our neighbors. Make sure that even during this winter season that they are warm and that they have a warm meal. Do join us again in the next edition of On the Pulse. I'm your host, Leslie Moyo.